Hi, my name is Christian Martirano. I'm here with the company Synthogy. We're exhibiting at the 2008 Frankfurt Musikmesse show, being hosted by the Time and Space booth, and I'm here to show you our products. The first product I'm going to show you is called Ivory Grand Pianos. It features three world-class pianos, the Busendorfer 290 Imperial, the Steinway Model D 9-foot Concert Grand, and the Yamaha C7 7-foot Concert Grand Piano. We'll start with the Busendorfer, and right now on our screen you're seeing the interface to Ivory, which is a common interface to all of the pianos I'll be showing you. So the user only needs to learn one interface. This is the Busendorfer. It was recorded at 10 different dynamic levels, and you'll hear a lot of dynamic variation in the sound. Next piano I'm going to load is our Steinway, the 9-foot Model D. It's a German piano. We did a lot of work to search the world for the finest pianos, so you don't have to. And then we did a lot of homework so that they were captured in a very authentic way, so that you could hear what the real pianos sound like in your recording studio or in your home. This is the German Steinway. Third piano in the collection is the Yamaha C7. This piano is very well suited for rock music or for jazz production, anything that requires a brighter piano. This collection, by the way, while this is loading, I should tell you, is a total of 40 gigabytes, and it'll run on a Mac or a PC. You need just a 7200 RPM drive, and the current version we're shipping is 1.7. that supports the new Leopard operating system for Macintosh, and also the iLock copy protection on the hardware key. So you can now load your library on many computers, just take your key from computer to computer without a lot of authorizing problems. It'll run immediately. So here's the Yamaha. I'm going to move into a new product that we're shipping called the Italian Grand. This is a 10-foot concert Italian piano, handcrafted. Has a gorgeous sound. It kind of has just a beautiful singing tone. It can be used for a wide variety of styles. This now comes with its own player, the Ivory Player engine. Has all of the great features, the effects, the built-in resonance models, soundboard models that we have all crafted here. And this one is recorded at 12 different dynamic levels. Now going to show our last title, which is a brand new title that features upright pianos. There's four of them. This starts with a very old, junky, beat-up piano. This was a very big request from our end users. Give us something that's reminiscent of the piano that was in my grandmother's basement, or something we might find in the basement of a church that has never been tuned. So this is very out of tune, but it's also a very classic kind of sound. Good for old blues. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm going to show some of the editing features found in the program. I've loaded in the German concert grand piano, the Model D, 9 foot, and I'm just going to make some edits on it quickly to show you some of the parameters. First, I'll play the sound just to remind us of what it sounds like. That's the raw piano, but now we make some changes. First off, we have a soundboard modeling for resonance. I'm going to put a much more resonant soundboard on it, increase the amount of resonance on the soundboard. I'm also going to add some release to the sound to make it kind of take longer to die away. Take some of the key noise out. And then I'm going to go into the panning stereo width, reduce the stereo width a little bit. Change the perspective to audience, which will change the panning. And then I'm going to go into my effects page. I have 2 bands of shelving EQ. I'm going to add a little bit more high end to the sound. And then I'm going to take a little bit of the bottom out. I'm looking for a thinner sound I'm going to create. I'm going to add a little bit of chorusing. We have many parameters you can adjust. And I'm going to add an effect here called curved space. Very interesting effect. I won't make it too wet. The end result I'm going to end up with will sound more like a pad and less like a piano. I'm going to turn on our synth layer, use a bit of the analog string layer, turn it up a little bit. And the end result we're going to hear now is going to be very different than that original Steinway piano. Impressive engine, and that you can do quite a lot of sound design with it beyond just the piano sound. And I hope you can see that. Thank you very much.